hot. Yeah. I want one, Daddy. Ooh.
So today I'm going to take you through a single session that I had on a Pyzel shadow in dark arts construction. The shadow is basically a toned down version of Pyzel's highly acclaimed ghost model. While the ghost was designed to tackle well overhead surf, the shadow is more of an everyday shortboard. It's the board that you'd see guys like John Florence or Jack Freestone riding in most CT events. This board is made in dark arts construction, which is kind of this new age carbon wrap where they cover the board top and bottom, then they vacuum bag it to thin out the carbon and remove excess resin, which makes the board super light. We've also seen the Florence brothers do some damage on these boards, so that seems like a good enough reason to try one. So the day that I surfed this board, the waves were actually really fun. You know, it was head high, clean, there were a couple little tubes. Basically the perfect conditions to try a new board. Initially, what I really liked about this board was that it had incredible like spring and pop. I felt it mainly when I was driving and going off the lip. When I made contact with the top of the wave, it would just kind of propel me back down to the bottom with even more speed, which I really loved. The one thing that I had a little bit of trouble with was getting the board on rail. It just didn't seem to want to dig into the water. It was just, it always felt like it was on top of the water. And I think that comes back to the dark arts construction. I typically ride EPS boards about half a liter less than PU, just because they have more natural buoyancy. But I think with the dark arts, you could go as much as a whole liter, maybe even a liter and a half less, just because they really do float. But what they kind of lack in that ability to really grip into the water, the dark arts construction makes up for it with its ability to release. So I found this board to be really, really good for airs. It had tons of spring and it was really strong, so it didn't get too affected by landings, which is always a good thing. All up, I found this construction to be really interesting. It had some really apparent benefits when it came to kind of pop and release, so that was kind of my takeaway.
There you go.
Thanks, coach.
What up, double? Yeah, that's a dope beat, man. I heard there was a spot popping off down the street. We could crash and smash a free long iced tea. Heard the bartender is a fan of the peak.
Ha, sounds like a mother, my brother. Right. Let me get my smash jeans, make sure my t-shirt's clean.